ओम तत्सत। गुड इवनिंग एंड नमस्ते टू ऑल। लेट अस लिसन टू वन मोर स्टोरी बाय ग्रैंडपा। स्टोरीज फ्रॉम द एनिमल वर्ल्ड, एनिमल्स इन द लाइव्स ऑफ एमिनेंट पर्सनैलिटीज। श्री आदिशंकर हू हैज initiated the tradition of Shankaracharyas by establishing the matha in all the four corners of our land Bharat. He was born in Kaladi, a small town in southernmost part of Bharat, Kerala. He was born to Shiv Sri Shivaguru and Aryamba. Sri Shivaguru had taken up a vow and was living a life of austerities and was involved in the worship of Shiva. Sri Shankara was born after that. So he was named as Shankara after Shiva. Shankara is one of the names of Shiva. At the age of 3, his father Sri Shivaguru passed away. And mother Aryamba brought him up. He was very bright, extraordinarily bright. At the age of 6, he had studied, learned the whole of Veda and all its allied subjects, Shastra, Upanishad. At the age of 7 or 8, he resolved to become a sannyasi. A renunciate, renounce the family life and walk off as a sannyasi. But being the only son of his mother, Aryamba did not give permission, and our shastras, our dharma says one cannot become a sannyasi without the permission of mother. So he wanted to seek the permission. There was always a discussion between him and his mother. What do you want me to do? She would say, you should enter the family life, you should get married. Then what? You should beget children, beget sons. What for? To continue our traditions. To continue our lineage. The generations should take my name. I want my grandchildren. So that they take my name, they continue my name. Now Adishankara, after having studied Veda, he had come across many of the tourists, the Tirthayatris, who had gone to the northern parts of Bharat and returned. And he had heard them in conversation with the elders of the town. They would say, they would describe the situation in northern parts, the impact of irreligious, atheistic, Buddha and Jaina religions on Vedic traditions, the challenges faced by institutions trying to protect weather, to teach weather, because emperors had also taken up these religions and they directly sponsored these religions and were prejudiciously placed against the Veda. So there was an atmosphere of threat to Vedic Dharma. That is what he gathered from those who had returned from north. So he had resolved to become a sannyasi so that the Hindu Dharma is re-established to its glorious ways. So he would reply to his mother, "Yes, I want to become sannyasi only to continue the tradition, the glorious tradition of our ancestors, only to establish our glorious traditions which have derailed due to these irreligious or atheistic religions. And you may have a few children directly as your grandchildren who will take your names. But if you allow me to become sannyasi, there will be hundreds of thousands of Hindus for the next few millenniums. They will be taking your name. They will be worshipping Aryamba," he would say. But the mother would not accept. This went on till one day, when he was almost 8 years old, he was caught by a crocodile in the local river. His leg was caught by the crocodile. Mother, who was on the banks, she cried. She wanted to do something but could not do anything to protect his son. She shouted, cried in despair. Now Adi Shankara said, "I am dead for you. The crocodile will swallow me. So even otherwise I am dead for you. If you permit me to take up sannyasa, I will be at least alive, roaming around anywhere. So you decide. If you give me the permission, I will become a sannyasi. If you don't, I am being gobbled up by this crocodile." The mother was desperate and she permitted him to become a sannyasi. And surprisingly, the crocodile left his leg and went away. Shankara came up on the stairs, bowed down to his mother and promised her, "I may be anywhere, but at the time of your end, the mortal life, I will be by your bedside. I assure you, I will definitely be on your side." So saying, he took up the path of sannyasa. He was initiated by Govindanath and he went away on his voyage, on his Tirthayatra. On foot, he roamed around the whole of Bharat, right up to Kedarnath and Kashmir, right up to the far east, Assam, Guwahati, and he roamed around to all places, revived Hindu Dharma, reconverted hundreds and lakhs of Hindus back to Vedic religion. He established many temples. He reinstated idols of various Hindu god forms, wrote beautiful poems on them. Hundreds of them. He wrote treatises on Veda, Upanishad, Bhagavad Gita. He did a tremendous work within a short span of around 20-22 years. And he lived up to the age of 32. At a later stage, we'll discuss the whole story, life story of Sri Shankara Shankara in more details. I conclude my story for the day. We'll meet tomorrow with one more story. Om Tat Sat.